Titanoboa was the largest snake ever discovered, which inhabited the tropical rainforests of Colombia during a period of warmer and more humid climate. Its reflexes were incredible, and it could strike with deadly precision, breaking its victim's neck in one swift motion. Despite the noise of the prehistoric jungle, the Titanoboa's stealth and agility made it nearly impossible for its prey to detect it. It was so powerful that it could capture any animal, regardless of its size or strength, as none could escape its grasp. In 2009, scientists discovered Titanoboa at the Sergin coal mine in Colombia. They found over 30 remains, mostly consisting of vertebrae and ribs, from both adult and juvenile individuals. They also uncovered a nearly complete specimen that included the skull. Based on these findings, experts estimate that adult Titanoboas could reach a length of up to 13 meters and weigh around 1.25 tons, making them much larger than the average adult anaconda, which is about 6.5 meters long. Although Titanoboa shares similarities with modern anacondas and boas, it is unclear which of these constrictor snakes it is more closely related to. However, the discovery of Titanoboa's fossils has provided invaluable insight into the evolutionary history of these ancient reptiles and the adaptations that allowed them to thrive in the tropical rainforests of South America. It's remarkable to note that the immense sizes of multiple Titanoboas discovered suggest that these ancient snakes typically grew up to 13 meters in length. This emphasizes the magnitude of these creatures, given that no living snake has ever been verified to exceed a length of 9.6 meters. Ectothermic reptiles benefit from warmer and stable temperatures, providing an ideal metabolism for efficient bodily functions and growth. Titanoboa's enormous size indicates that global temperatures were significantly higher 60 million years ago compared to today, as modern snakes in equatorial regions are much smaller. Understanding the impact of ancient climates on reptile growth is a crucial component of paleontological and evolutionary research. Although it's theoretically possible for larger snakes to emerge with future global warming, it's unlikely due to disappearing habitats and human interference. Additionally, the global warming we're experiencing now is happening much faster than the long-term warming that led to Titanoboa's massive body size 60 million years ago. As a result, it's unlikely that we'll see such enormous snakes again anytime soon. Titanoboa's fossils suggest that this snake species primarily inhabited watery environments because its enormous size would have made movement on land challenging, if not impossible. Therefore, the snake likely spent most of its time in aquatic habitats, such as swamps and marshes, similar to the modern-day anaconda. Titanoboa was a massive prehistoric snake with a unique ability to regulate its body temperature through a process called ectothermy or cold-bloodedness. Unlike mammals, which can control their body temperature internally, Titanoboa's body temperature was dependent on its surroundings. To regulate its body temperature, Titanoboa would bask in the sun and absorb heat. This process called thermoregulation helped the snake to increase its body temperature and become more active. It also facilitated faster digestion, which was vital for a predator that preyed on large animals. The ability to regulate its body temperature was critical to Titanoboa's success as a predator in its swampy tropical environment. By adjusting its body temperature, Titanoboa could increase its activity level and hunt for food more efficiently, giving it an advantage over other predators. Titanoboa was a highly skilled predator that employed ambush tactics and lightning-fast strikes to capture a diverse range of prey, including crocodiles, turtles, fish, and other animals present in its natural environment. Although it shared some physical similarities with modern-day anacondas, Titanoboa likely had a distinct hunting style. Instead of suffocating its prey by wrapping around them, it would silently and swiftly stalk its target and deliver a lethal bite to the jugular, allowing it to savor its meal at a leisurely pace. There is a popular but erroneous belief that the Titanoboan dinosaurs engaged in fierce battles, and that the Titanoboa may have even preyed on the dinosaurs. However, paleontologists unanimously agree that such contests never took place. The reason being that the Titanoboa lived during the Paleocene epoch, which occurred millions of years after the extinction of dinosaurs during the Cretaceous tertiary extinction event. Therefore, it is impossible for the Titanoboa to have faced off with dinosaurs. Despite not crossing paths with dinosaurs, the Titanoboa still had to face formidable opponents in the form of prehistoric crocodiles. These crocodiles were known to inhabit the same regions as the Titanoboa, and they were among the largest predators of their time. The Titanoboa's size would have certainly deterred some predators, but prehistoric crocodiles were likely among the few predators that could have put up a fight against the Titanoboa. It is unclear whether the Titanoboa and the crocodiles ever engaged in confrontations, but it's reasonable to believe that they posed a significant threat to each other. There is no definitive answer as to why the Titanoboa went extinct. Two theories have been proposed to explain why Titanoboa, the largest snake ever known to exist, went extinct around 58 million years ago. The first theory suggests that a decrease in global temperature played a significant role. As the temperature dropped, smaller snakes adapted better to the changing environment and outcompete the larger Titanoboa. Additionally, the colder temperature made it difficult for Titanoboa's metabolism to function properly, which may have contributed to its eventual extinction. The second theory focuses on habitat loss. As rainforests receded and grasslands took over, Titanoboa's habitat shrank, making it increasingly difficult for them to find food and survive. This led to a decline in the Titanoboa population and eventually their extinction. Smaller snakes were better adapted to the changing habitat and took over the ecological niche that Titanoboa once occupied. It's important to note that these two theories are not mutually exclusive, and both factors may have played a role in Titanoboa's extinction. Climate change and habitat loss are just two of the many factors that can contribute to the extinction of a species, and the exact cause of Titanoboa's extinction may never be fully understood. Thanks for watching this video. We hope you found it interesting to discover this incredible creature. Please remember to support us by giving it a thumbs up, leaving a comment, and subscribing to our channel so that you won't miss out on any exciting content coming up.